Today is my first day of vlogging what I'm eating for the next week's video of my keto accountability for October challenge. So this collab is awesome. Don't forget to check all of the other YouTubers' channels down below and see what they are doing and what their tips and tricks and struggles and all that are. And hey, you might get some help. You know, somebody might answer a question that you've been wondering about, or just ask us questions. You know, we're all out there to help each other and support each other. So my daily, never gonna be able to get away from thing is my coffee. So I usually have, there's like a hazelnut pod that Kroger carries, K-Cup. So I usually have that with, I still have like, I had one more after today. I've got one more little bit left of the sugar-free caramel macchiato creamer. I'm not going to buy any more of that because I usually have just been doing that one in the morning. Then in the evening, for like in my evening coffee, I will have the almond milk creamer, the unsweetened almond milk creamer. So I'm just going to go straight to nothing but the almond milk creamer. And then at some point, I'm going to try to go from that to just the unsweetened almond milk because it's not as thick, but I just can't have my coffee without something creamy in it. And then I have the skinny syrups, and I've also got erythritol, stevia drops. So, you know, depending on what I want in my coffee for that day. So I had my coffee this morning when I left the house, which was like 6:45. So usually I sip on that for a little bit. And I've gotten to the point where now I don't really have a breakfast planned. I'm trying not to have breakfast. And once I am done with this creamer tomorrow and I go just to the almond milk creamer, it's going to be 50 calories or less. So I might actually kind of be more like an intermittent fasting until I eat something. I'm trying to extend that out a little bit because I've tried intermittent fasting stuff before, and that's always been a struggle for me because I can't go longer than like 4 hours probably without food, except for in the evening. Like, I'll finish eating my dinner and I'll have coffee or whatever, and after 6 o'clock, 99% of the time I don't have anything until the next morning. So I'm still fasting to an extent, but it's not as long as I would like. You know, I'd like to just not have breakfast at all. And on the weekends it's not hard because sometimes I sleep a little bit later. I don't get up at 6 o'clock, I get up at like 8. And I'll have a coffee and I'll wait a couple hours and I'll just have lunch at 11 because I'm used to having lunch around 11, 11:30. So stay tuned for a video of where I'm reviewing these Shroof Food protein crisps, and I am doing a higher protein form of keto. Oh, brain. Because that's what worked for me. I've been down the normal route until I got to a point where I had to change things up and lower my fat of my protein. And Keto in the Chaos is a great channel to check out for that. She's awesome. So I'm having some of these for, sometimes I'll have a half a bag if I eat these things, or I'll have the whole thing, but it's something that I need to put something in my belly right now, because I'm one of those people, if I don't eat within so long of like starting to get really, really hungry, I'll feel nauseated. So I'm almost at that point now. So I'm gonna eat this and then I'll show you what I have for lunch. My lunch is usually the same thing during the week, unless I have some extra leftovers from dinner or something. But we usually leave our leftovers for another dinner. So I alternate basically between the 5 ounce cans of chicken or tuna with a tablespoon of the avocado mayonnaise, and then sometimes I'll have a few regular pork rinds. I've found Max have like the best flavor to me for a plain, and then a two good yogurt. So that is my average lunch. That's what I'm having today. Dinner tonight is taco chicken. My husband, when he has his, he'll put sour cream on it and sometimes some shredded cheese, and it's just like a bowl. We don't usually eat anything with it. Sometimes I'll use it to make enchiladas with, but I'm just eating some in a bowl. That's my dinner. It is Thursday. Today for breakfast I am having these Shroof Food nacho flavored protein crisp. I was doing my taste test, so I figured since they're open, I'll have that for my breakfast today. This is going to be my lunch today. Two of these ranch packets and a Two Good yogurt. And then later, if I get hungry, I do bring a cola Zevia to work every day. So if I end up wanting something like that, I will probably end up having this Atkins bar, the white chocolate macadamia nut. It's really, really good. Here is taco chicken one more time. All right, it's Friday. Today I actually decided to go to McDonald's and get a sugar-free vanilla iced coffee. I do get those maybe once a week. No, I don't even do it once a week anymore. It's more like once every couple of weeks, if that. And then I'm really hungry this morning, so I'm actually gonna have this pumpkin pie crust bar. They're really good. Lunch for today is the last little bit of taco chicken that was left. And when I have my Zevia later, I'm probably gonna have my Atkins snack bar. All right, so dinner tonight is, I've got some ground beef that I took a pound of ground beef, the 80-20. And I just put a packet of the ranch seasoning in there. One of these. There's one carb per half teaspoon. So that's on all I put in there. Well, actually, no, a lot. I put a little bit of my salt, pepper in there, which I use the white salt. I kept saying new salt or no salt, but it's the light salt. So it's got salt, but then it also is potassium in there. And then with it, I'm having the bird's eye cauliflower mash. This is the sour cream and chives one. It's really good. I like it the way it is. We enjoy the taste of it exactly the way it is right out of the microwave. And a lot of people will doctor it up. They'll put some extra cheese and sour cream, you know, whatever you want in there if you want. But I think it tastes great the way it is. And on these, serving size is half a cup for 90 calories, 6 fat, 8 carbs, minus 3 fiber. So 5 carbs and 3 protein. So I am going to have this with this, and that's my dinner. Breakfast this morning is French toast made with the zero carb bread from Aldi. For my afternoon snack, which technically it's only an hour and a half after I've had lunch and I'm still hungry, so I'm gonna have this birthday cake quest bar. Dinner tonight is this chicken noodle soup I made with the egg noodles. Stay tuned, and I will be posting this video on how I made it. After this, I'll probably have a coffee. This morning I am having some, I guess these are technically waffles because they're made out of just egg and almond flour, but they're like French toast style, so they're not crunchy. There's no cheese on there, but I figured if they're not sweet enough or good enough by themselves, I'll use my sugar-free syrup from Kroger. So I'm going to have two of those for breakfast today, and then I've got my coffee ready, which I actually am using this pumpkin pod because I got a box of these from, what was it? Where was that? Not TJ Maxx, but Home Goods. And then I'm using my almond milk creamer and this salted caramel skinny syrup. So that's really good. I like it. That one's puffier. I obviously put more in the other one. I'll let it get a little bit darker. But that's my breakfast, guys. I'm having some leftover chicken soup for lunch. I didn't feel like making any more noodles. It's just, I'm kind of lazy today. But hey, it's still really good even without the egg noodles in there. My mid-afternoon snack slash sweet-ish thing is a chocolate chip cookie dough protein bar from Quest. Almost forgot to video eating the last little bit of the soup for dinner. Since there's only a little bit left, I'm gonna finish that off and have some pork rinds.
Tonight I am sort of meal prepping. I've got some onions and peppers cooked, and I'm cooking that good deal on that meat I got, a couple pounds of it, for that Sloppy Joe recipe that's in the Southern Keto cookbook. Please go get that cookbook. And even if you go online and like buy the digital version, which I did, it's such an awesome cookbook. There's some great stuff in there. And we love the Sloppy Joe recipe. So I can't give it out because it's out of a book. So you'll have to go get that book if you want it. But it's great. It really is. So I'm meal prepping a little bit. I'm going ahead and making this for tomorrow night. I went ahead and cut up the rest of the celery and put it in a little bag so my husband can have it for snacks with like ranch dressing for work. And I'm cooking this up for our next few meals. And he should be getting off of work soon. And that's about it for my Sunday. I've been lazy. My whole weekend I've been lazy. I just haven't had the energy to do anything. And I'm like, I don't know what to do with myself. So that's it for Sunday. I'm going to have a coffee. And I'm going to actually cut up and put that big pack of chicken in some freezer bags that I got from the store. So that'll be separated and freezing. See you guys tomorrow. All right, it's Monday. So I had my coffee on the way to work, which had my almond milk creamer and my skinny syrup in there. And then for breakfast, I'm going to have some more of these protein crisps. This is the sour cream and onion one. Lunch for today is two of these tuna packets and a strawberry Too Good yogurt. Tonight's dinner, I am heating up the Sloppy Joe stuff I made last night, and I am making the Cheddar Bay chop bowl. I found the best way to do this is just to make one, and we just put it on the plate and then we dump the stuff on top of it and just eat it like that. I mean, you can make it with two if you want it to actually be like a Sloppy Joe, kind of like a sandwich, but we feel like, you know, one good serving on top of one nice chaffle is perfect. The Cheddar Bay biscuit chaffle recipe, it's really easy. It's just one egg, 2 tablespoons of almond flour, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, and 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder, and a pinch of salt. It's really easy. So, oh, I'm sorry, and 1/4 cup of cheddar, and I use mild. So it just depends on what kind of cheddar you want to use. And I usually do it just like with the other chaffles. I put a little cheese down on the bottom and a little on top, so you get some crispiness. Makes it really good when you're having the Sloppy Joe mix on it. So there it is, piled onto my chaffle. Good morning, it's Tuesday. My hair's still wet because I haven't been at work hardly in like 10 minutes. Got my coffee with my almond milk creamer this morning, and I'm gonna have these baked cheddar crisps for breakfast. I'm gonna have to start bringing my egg white, little egg white, what do you call them things? Egg bites, my egg white egg bites. I'm gonna have to go back to bringing those next week because these will be gone. Actually later this week, because this is my last one except for part of the little Parmesan ones. But that video will be coming out soon where I reviewed all those flavors for those shrewd food protein snacks. So today is the last day of the first week of the accountability collab and the Keto Through the Holidays collab. So I am going to have that video done today, and you'll see this then. So I don't know why I'm even telling you about it. But this morning I weighed in at 205.6. Last Monday was 210.6. So I've actually lost 5 pounds since last Monday. So I'm at a total of 94.4 pounds lost since January 13th when I started at 300 pounds. I can't believe I'm almost at 100. It's still really hard. It hasn't sunk in yet. Some days I feel like I know I can look at myself and physically see I'm smaller, but I don't see almost 100 pounds difference until I go and look at some of those pictures like I showed you guys last week. I mean, it's crazy. But anyway, that has been my week. I will show you what I have for lunch today and for dinner, which nothing crazy. It's basically the same thing that I had yesterday. I'm gonna try to get some pictures of me and my husband together this weekend so you can see a difference in him, because he's actually at his biggest, he was at about 190 and he's like 5'10". And now he's at 155 and he's been there for a little bit. So, and he didn't really have a bunch of size to him. He just had a little bit of a belly, which we always said was hereditary because the men in his family had bellies, even whether they didn't drink or not. And he doesn't drink either. So, but he's always had the belly. So now he's basically got no belly left. And he's a man, so he halfway eats keto sometimes and still loses weight. But he's doing great. He's been my best, biggest supporter, and I love him. He's my best friend. So for lunch today, like I said, it's not going to be anything special. I'm having 2 packets of tuna, the ranch flavored ones, and a 2 good yogurts. I try not to eat tuna every day because the mercury stuff, you know, I at least try to alternate it, but I did have some yesterday, but it wasn't a lot. So tomorrow I'll have chicken. I'll try to skip a day in between. And then in a little while, when I have my afternoon Zevia, I will have this Atkins white chocolate macadamia nut bar. Dinner tonight is another serving of our Sloppy Joes with our Cheddar Bay chocolate. Yeah. So that was the end of my first week of the Keto Accountability Collab and the first week of keto through the holidays. So how did you guys do? Did you do okay? Did you have a good week? Did you stay on track? Did you have any problems? My best thing that I can say as far as like tips and tricks go is if you find something that works, stay doing what you're doing. Don't keep trying to change stuff and trying new things all the time, because I'm bad for that. And I've learned, oh, I want to try this dessert, or I want to try that dessert, or I've made, you know, this keto sweet and I want to have, you know, multiples of them because they're here. And it's just one of those things that I'm really bad about and want to try new things. And right now I am determined to reach a goal. And I'm going to try not to try new things very often. If I do, it's going to be like one of those things where, okay, I'll try this one thing today. Not, you know, I'm going to make this big batch of keto desserts and eat on them all week. Because, you know, it's just me and my husband here right now until Christmas time. So the kids won't be eating them, you know. That's going to probably be the hardest thing when it comes to holiday time, is making that stuff. And then it's going to be here. Because we make more of that stuff that time of year. That's just the way we're brought up as humans. You know, you celebrate through that time of year, and celebrate always means food. So, I had a good week. I still can't believe I went down as much as I did during this week, but I've been trying to keep pretty much the same food every day, even though it can get a little boring sometimes. I'm just trying to keep everything where I need it to be. Again, all the other channels that are in this accountability collab are listed below. So go check out all their channels. Give them some love. I'm sorry, guys. I work next to the shop. Go give them some love. Go talk to them on their channels. Like their videos. Watch their videos. And again, I appreciate everybody that's here. Everybody that has liked my channel, that watches my videos, and that interacts, and I really appreciate it because it helps my channel grow. And thank you so much for being here. So I hope you guys had a great week, and I will see you on next Tuesday. Bye, guys.